Hello everyone, Russ of Aquarimax Pets here. In today's video, we're going to focus on distinguishing three types of Armadillidium isopods known for their yellow markings. We're going to start out with Armadillidium maculatum yellow. You can see that this specimen does have some yellow coloration in the stripes that are across its body, but they're not nearly as yellow as, say, Armadillidium gestroi. And they tend to be in either stripes or broken stripes that somewhat resemble spots. This is, as far as we know, not a naturally occurring locality. There may be some localities with more yellow coloration than others, but this shows up in captive populations and does breed true. So this species is also, on average, not as large as the other two, but I have seen large specimens, probably as large as either of these of the other two species, but that seems to be a rarity. I've only seen only one of my specimens that big. In general, their average adult size is smaller. I think that's safe to say. And now let's focus on Armadillidium granulatum. The name granulatum means granulated and refers to the rough surface that you can see on this isopod, especially in macro shots. As you can see here, though it does have yellow markings, the markings are less vivid and less clear-cut than the markings on Armadillidium gestroi. They have, they're broken up a little bit by these small spots, and the surface of the isopod itself is less glossy than in gestroi, and also a lighter gray color, which makes for less contrast. So while it is an attractive isopod, it doesn't, in my opinion, have this stunning quality that Armadillidium gestroi has. This is also one of the more highly marked, this Armadillidium granulatum is one of the more highly marked individuals in my colony. I would say in general that there is a higher expression on most gestroi. Some have less than this gestroi does, but they tend to have in general more than Armadillidium granulatum, which brings us to the last species in this deli cup today, Armadillidium gestroi, and we've already discussed a lot of the differences, but one thing I will point out is that you can see that in this specimen, the spots are not only larger, more vivid, more clear, cleaner, they're not interrupted by little bits of gray coloration as they are in granulatum, but there are more of them, a larger distribution, and while they do vary from specimen to specimen, a lot of them appear in a kind of a wedge shape, like a vague triangle. Some are almost perfect triangles, and some are just sort of a vague triangle splotch. And you'll also notice in this particular specimen, it has one spot of yellow on one side of the, just above the rostrum or the face, and on the other corresponding side, it doesn't have them. So they can be uneven like they are in gestroi, but generally they're bigger, brighter, cleaner, and more well-defined against the darker color of gestroi. And so, if you were curious about the differences between these three species of Armadillidium isopods, I hope that helps clear up any confusion you might have had. And thanks for watching. I post videos every Friday with live streams on Wednesdays, all about aquarium and vivarium pets with lots of isopod content. Please feel free to share, rate, comment, and if you haven't already,
subscribe.
And then tap the bell for all notifications so you don't miss my next video.